Good morning. I am Sunil from St. Martin Engineering College. So from mechanical department. Today I will discuss about the subject that is called strength of material. Strength of material. So everyone should know the strength is one type of in the other life. If you have human only for material, for anything we purchase, we first we check the quality. Same thing, if any material is made by some materials, made plastic, wooden, metals, in we concern with mechanical engineering. So we'll study about metals. So we have to check the what is the strength of the that material by applying various phenomena like bending, momentum, what the stress is acting on, what is the load is acting, what is the deformation, what is the bending moment, all those we are studying. First we'll discuss about shear force and bending momentum of the material when you add the load. So here the member is divided into three to four types. One is they are carrying the member as a beam. First one is cantilever beam. Next one is a beam, simply supported beam. Third one, C is a overhanging beam, and D is fixed beam. So if your cantilever beam is there, it has one side fixed, another end is free. One end is fixed, another end is free. It is called cantilever beam. Simply supported beam, there is no fix, just the beam is resting on some support. That is called simply supported beam. If overhanging beam is there, means we have two supports, but that it is extended to from one support. So same way as a fixed beam means the both end of the beam is fixed. These are the types of beams. Again, we have the loads. You should know first what type of the member will be there and what type of the loads is acting. We have three loads. One is called point load or concentrated load. Point or concentrated load. Second one is called UDL or uniformly distributed load. Third one we call as UVL, uniformly varying load. So what about this point load? The point load, when you taking the point load, the load which acts at small area. The load which is acting at small area. Okay, that is at a point. We call as point. Second one is UDL, as the name indicates, uniformly distributed load. Uniformly distributed. In entire span of the length, load is uniformly distributed or equally distributed over the span of beam. If second, third one, you can see that UVL, uniformly varying, means at the point to point, as the length increases or decreases, load is going to increase or decrease. depends upon the nature. As the length increases, load may be increased, or as the length decreases, load may be increased. Like this. You have two types. These are the basics when you are going to study the shear force and bending momentum diagram. Also, the sign convention of the taking the loads. It is a one axis will take. We take right side. At the right side, if the load is acting towards downward, we take as positive, whereas up is negative. It's opposite to the left side. Similarly, downward is negative, towards upward is positive. Only load concerned. If you take the momentum, same, okay. So if it is anti-clockwise, form here positive, clockwise is negative. Here is opposite. Anti-clockwise is negative, clockwise is positive. If you know this one thing, so we go to combination of both beams and loads, we can study the what is the behavior of those material. If you say we have stresses in that one and strains in that one, so stress is nothing but force by area, and load strain is nothing but deformation. If the material undergoes change in length, that's called strain, whereas if the load is so next topic is a stress. So when you study these all things, we will study the stress, what happened to the material when you add the load. It's indicated by sigma. It's nothing but force by area. The force will be measured in terms of Newton, area is in terms of meter. If any changes occurs in the dimension of the material, change in area or change in length, we call as strain. Strain is nothing but capacity of the material which can withstand the load acting on that material. How much it can oppose us? It's a small e. Okay, so symbol is nothing but change in length by original length, or it is change in thickness by original thickness. Okay. So after, if you know these all the things, sign convention, the stress and strain, so we can go for the what is first we took as cantilever beam. Cantilever beam. What is cantilever beam behavior when you add the load? So cantilever beam means what? One end is fixed, another end is free. First I will take concentrated load at the free end. Free end. So say that is W. Length of this span is L. So that now, as the name shear force and bending moment, we have to find out. So that it is a section. All the forces towards right, shear forces. What are the shear forces? Shear force. I'll mark point A, point B. So we'll take one reference axis here. Reference axis. So shear force at a point B. Shear force at the point B, it is FB. It's the right side. Coming downward, so that W. If the take the section at the middle, if you take the shear force at the point A, is the left side, okay? There no force is acting here, so it is W only acts till A. So we can simply we draw the axis first. One axis, mark the point A and mark the point B. The all are positive load. And if you take the bending momentum, similarly force into length, you can measure, you can find the momentum of the material.